There is this Meghan Trainor song a while back, and I'm sure it was on the radio a ton. I'm sure you're familiar with it, but it was, "'Cause I'm all about that bass, no trouble." What in the world does that have to do with the Bible? I will tell you in a second. Welcome back to the Road to Emmaus journey, and today we are looking at the book of Titus, and we're in the second chapter. And the reason I mention that is because around that same time, there was a group that was in our city, and they're teaching all of these crazy heretical things, but it kind of revolved around this hyper grace movement. And if you're not familiar with that, it was just this aspect that we as Christians don't have a sin nature. In fact, we can't sin. We can never do anything displeasing to God because all of God's displeasure was poured out on Christ. And so with this hyper grace, it was just, it went into licentiousness. There was just no contrition or repentance from sin because we are under grace. And grace became this caveat to be able to indulge the desires of the flesh, and God wouldn't be mad at us because we're under grace. It's okay. And Titus will correct us on that. But the Meghan Trainor song, at that same time, there was a group of us that were almost making fun of this kind of teaching, this hyper grace teaching. And we replaced some of the words, and it was, "'Cause I'm all about that grace, no devil." And so it just reminded me of that. But Titus chapter 2, verse 11 is something that is so definitional when we talk about God's grace. It says in verse 11, "For the grace of God has appeared, bringing salvation for all people, training us to renounce ungodliness and worldly passions, and to live self-controlled, upright, and godly lives in this present age, waiting for our blessed hope and appearing of the glory of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ, who gave himself for us to redeem us from all lawlessness and to purify for himself a people for his own possession who are zealous for good works. Declare these things, exhort and rebuke with all authority. Let no one disregard you." This is really powerful because it makes some contrasts and it makes some pretty definitive claims here about God's grace. The first of which is that God's grace, or our thinking of it, shouldn't be that, oh, God is fine with everything. No, instead it says that it trains us to renounce ungodliness, that the grace of God is instructive. It would have us do something. Ultimately, that we would be a purified people, meaning that we would rid ourselves of the things of this world and that we'd actually be zealous for good works, not just for indulging our own flesh. In fact, it says that we are to renounce ungodliness and worldly passions and to live self-controlled, upright, and godly lives in this present age. So what's really interesting is these people that were teaching kind of this heresy that there is no sin nature, they said, oh, well, that's Old Testament. That's the old law. Now we're under grace. And yet Paul here says, no, in this present age, we are to live lives of self-control, of uprightness, of godliness because of the grace of God. So this is absolutely relevant for the church in 2020, as much as it was to Paul writing Titus at that time. And it's interesting because we often don't equate grace to being self-controlled. We often don't think of grace as being a renouncing of the things we want. We can often use it as an excuse to live our lives in the flesh, but nothing could be further according to Titus chapter 2. I'd love to hear your thoughts. Please comment below, and thanks for joining us on the Road to Emmaus journey.